he is allowed his job back. I just can't believe it.
New at 6, a story you'll see only on WISN 12 tonight. The handcuffed woman punched by a Milwaukee police officer speaks out for the first time since that officer got his job back. For months, that woman has been the face in the dash cam video.
And tonight, she's speaking only to WISN 12 News' Colleen Henry. And Colleen, the woman fears now for public safety.
Yeah, you know, Jason, Janine Tracy told 12 News when she learned there was dashboard video of that police officer punching her here in the garage of the 7th District Station, she figured he'd at least lose his job. Tonight, she's afraid he'll soon be back on the street.
For Janine Tracy, a routine traffic stop turned into a terrifying confrontation with a Milwaukee police officer. A dashboard camera captured the blows to Tracy's head by an officer who said she was combative and he feared she would bite or spit at him.
For this to turn out the way it did is, like I said, it just takes me back. Like the hurt starting all over again.
Chief Ed Flynn fired Officer Richard Shane last spring, but after a two-day hearing, Milwaukee's Fire and Police Commission overturned the chief's decision. Shane spoke with 12 News just minutes after he got his job back.
I still feel I was somewhat justified, but that's up for other people to decide.
Sitting in her lawyer's office, Tracy is struggling with Shane's reinstatement.
It was even more scary to have seen, you know, what he said or stated on the news. Like, it was nothing. Like I'm not important.
Tracy's lawyer says Shane's reinstatement won't affect their case, but he believes it will hurt police-community relations.
It is the wrong message to allow an officer who does that back on the force. It's just the wrong message entirely.
Tracy says she's been in counseling since the arrest. The sight of a squad car still scares her.
I know it's good officers out there, but I know what Richard Shawn did has made it hard, you know, for the good cops. He shows no remorse, like heartless. Yeah, it's sad. And this is who we call when we have a problem here in our community.
Now, late this afternoon, a spokesman for the Milwaukee Police Union issued a statement noting that the Fire and Police Commission heard 14 hours of testimony. Quote, it is absolutely irresponsible for anyone who was not present at the hearing to question the authority and decision of the commissioners. Now, none of the commissioners who voted to reinstate the officer returned 12 News calls for comment. And finally, it is unclear when or if Officer Shane will return to District 7. We've made several inquiries to the police department that have not been returned. At the 7th District, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
Thanks, Colleen.